Hello guys, welcome to Greenfish Nation. I want to thank you for joining the channel today. Guys, we're going to be heading out to the honey hole. We're going to try out a new bait that we purchased at Academy. It's a little 3-inch multi-jointed baby crappie glide bait. So you guys stay tuned for fishing from Greenfish Nation. All right, guys, I got this little wiggle crappie. I guess you'd call that a glide bait. That's what I call it. Guys, thanks again for joining the video today. I wanted to give you a heads up. There's a big fish at the end of this video, so try to stay tuned for the whole thing. I'm going to tie my lures on with this. It's a modified San Diego jam knot. It works real good. Try and lubricate that thing before you pull it down, and then pull your knot tight, pull against it. Seems to make a pretty good knot. Just cut that tag end off there. Close as you can, and we're fishing. Nice, quick, easy. You don't have to worry about it doing a bunch of twisting. I have never throwed this lure either. It's gonna be a pretty cool little old lure. It looks like I'm gonna hold my rod up kind of high and reel it kind of fast and see if we can't fool something into thinking that we're running from it. Try to keep this thing out of the grass. You guys can see that thing or not swimming through there, but it looks pretty good. And it's kind of heavy, so it's gonna throw good in this wind. This is a little old H2O jointed crappie I got at Academy. Just move around and see what we can come up with here. See if anybody's hungry for a little baby crappie today. Spins when you throw it, but you know you can't have it all. Oh, that fella right there was hungry for a baby crappie. So I believe I'll eat a little old crappie today. A little better fish than that jerkbait fish. Easy fella. He's trying to. I'm gonna have to go get my pliers. I'll be right back. There. I got back and he had already unhooked himself. We'll see if anybody else wants to eat some crappie.
Hey guys, I want to mention a new channel that you guys should check out along with Texas Reeli'n. You should also check out Teel Fishing. It's Eddie's buddy Adam, so you guys go and check that channel out.
Yeah, that fella right there said he'd take a crappie. Must be his brother.
I
tell you what, them little hooks, they are sharp. Well, there's another one. Well, let's try another one. They seem to be liking to eat crappie today. Maybe they just wanted something that was moving a little faster. Cold as this water is, that's hard to believe. Pretty close to the bank, it seems like, too. There's another one on the little crappie. Man, I tell you what, I think that thing just right next to the bank. And I mean, he hit right on it. Maybe we ought to throw down this way on the bank. See what we can come up with. Well, that wasn't exactly what I had planned. Well, let's walk on down here. Be laying up close to the bank in that water that's warming up a little quicker or something. I don't know if that was a fish or if I drug bottom. Might have been a fish. We'll give him another shot at it. That was grass. Thank you. All right, guys, we've moved over to the other side of the pond. Against the wind, but at least the sun be out of your eyes. We're gonna throw this little crappie over here and see what we can come up with. There's one right there. There he is. He just knocked a fire out of it right there. Guys, I can't say I blame these little fishies. What about y'all, but I like eating crappie myself. I got my fly tying stuff located. So I'm gonna try to do a video here in a couple days while I'm at work over the holidays on tying some bass flies. Maybe next week we might come out here and try to catch us a bass on a fly rod. Just kind of fan casting this thing around. Letting it sink just a little bit. Rolling it at a moderate speed. Trying to talk something into biting. Got some of those Berkeley gillies. They're weedless. Kind of makes me think about them this spring. The fish are bedding. Oh, there's one right there. Tried it, guys. He tried it. He just was not committed enough. Getting back to those Berkeley gillies. Trying one of them this spring, pitching around them spawning bass beds. I bet we might do some good with them. Pitch that thing in there and you just kind of let it lay. This thing here's got treble hooks on it. I don't think that'd be a good idea for it, probably. It's not real heavy. Probably weighs 3/4 of an ounce and it's big old flat sides on it, so it tends to catch the wind. So it kind of flops and spins around. Well, let's walk on down a little bit and we'll drive on down there to that flat down there. We'll walk on here a little bit and see what we can't get ourselves into. We got ourselves into another little fish. Oh, you get through wiggling, let me know. I'll get a hold of you and get that thing out of your face for you, okay? Thank you, sir. Thank you.
while it hung on the bottom there for a minute. There's another one. A little old crappie. I'd say it's more like a flat-sided crankbait, I guess, than it would be a glide bait. Got to get in here and see if I can figure out how to do surgery and get this hook out of this fella. Man, he got that thing in there in a bad kind of way. Hooked it right in the bottom of his tongue. I guess you might want to call it a jointed, flat-sided crankbait. It's almost like a jointed rattle trap without the rattle. All right, guys, we're down here on this last little neck. Mr. Crappie here. See what we can come up with. See if he can produce for us. We're gonna kind of fish down that way, and then we'll kind of fish down that way. There's one right there. Ah, I don't know if that was a fish or grass. I think it was a fish. Oh boy, I hope y'all got that one. Man, he was hot on his tail. Rolled right there at that grass. Darkness nearly drowned me.
Sunlight low, don't it burn my eyes? Darkness nearly drowned me. Sunlight low, don't it burn my eyes? This valley is much too deep, and this mountain so very high. My cup is nearly empty. I got such a long, long way to go. My cup is nearly empty. I got such a long, long way to go. I got to lay down here.
All right, guys, here's a spoiler. Big fish is coming up.
Darkness nearly drowned me. Sunlight burned my eyes. This valley is much.
This feels like this might be a little bit better fish right here.
I gotta lay down and rest. Take another step down this lonesome road.
I'd say it is.
My cup is nearly empty. I got such a long, long, long way to go.
That's a little better fish, guys. I don't have my scales, but guys, that right there is going to be about 4 pounds. Guys, what do y'all think about that one? Let's get him on out there in the water.
Sunlight burned my eyes. This valley is much too deep in this mountain so very high.
That's the kind of fish we come down here for.
Such a long, long, long way to go. Yeah, my cup is nearly empty.
That old big fish, she was hungry for a crappie too.
Sunlight low, don't burn my eyes. darkness nearly drowned me in the sunlight, Lord, don't it burn my eyes. This valley is much too deep, and this mountain so very high. Well, my cup is nearly empty, I got such a long, long way to go. My cup is nearly empty. Got such a long, long way to go. I got to lay down here and rest before I can take another step down that lonely road where the darkness nearly drowned me. Sunlight burned my eyes. This valley is much too deep. Mountain so very high, I gotta lay down and rest, or I can take another step down Thompson Road.
Hey guys, I want to thank you for joining the channel today. Guys, I appreciate you watching. That little crappie bait, as you can see, is going to be a good addition to anyone's tackle box, especially this time of year. So guys, next time you're out, see about picking one of those up. Until next time, I'm John with Greenfish Nation. I want to wish all of you tight lines.